Liquid nitrogen gets amazingly cold, and hundreds of you and we wanted to know what would happen if we put cotton candy into liquid nitrogen, and when we tried it out, the result was very surprising. To show what we expect to happen when we dip something into liquid nitrogen, let's take a few flowers and leaves, freeze them in the liquid nitrogen, and smack them on this brick and watch what happens. Exploded. Let's try it with one of this flower. I don't know what this flower is called, but we're gonna freeze it and then see if it shatters. Shattered. Now we've got a little leaf. Let's try it with the leaf. Breaks as if it were an old dry leaf in the fall. Turns to powder basically. And then as it warms up, it just goes back to being flexible. We know how flowers and leaves react when we put it in the liquid nitrogen, and so I expected something similar to happen with cotton candy. It's very thin, and I thought that perhaps as it froze, it would become less flexible and more brittle, but that's not what happened. Here's the basic idea. We'll take some cotton candy, quickly drop it down into the liquid nitrogen, pull it out, and smash it down on this brick, and see if it shatters or if something else happens. We'll follow that up by seeing if we get the same result if we leave the cotton candy in the liquid nitrogen for a longer period of time. The cotton candy dipped in liquid nitrogen acts almost exactly like a normal cotton ball dipped in water. Normally, you can't have wet cotton candy. You put it into water and it just dissolves immediately, but the sugar that cotton candy is made of doesn't dissolve in liquid nitrogen. As a result, the cotton candy soaks up the liquid nitrogen just like a normal cotton ball soaking up water. Look at that, it's dripping out from cotton candy. Cotton candy is dry or it's dissolved normally. So this was really surprising when we tried it out. Look at this, you can even squeeze the liquid nitrogen right out of it. Soaking it up like a sponge. It is now saturated with liquid nitrogen. Ah, it splashed onto my neck. I know what cotton candy is like normally if I eat it. I'm a little bit nervous about trying to eat it when it's been dipped in liquid nitrogen because, as you've just seen, it acts like a sponge almost. I think if I have the cotton candy dipped in liquid nitrogen and then put it in my mouth, it would just burn my mouth. All of that liquid nitrogen would freeze inside of my mouth shut. So I'm gonna dip it in and then try breaking off just a little piece of it. See how that goes. Oh, here we go. I missed. Don't show that. Or do. Ooh, that is very cold. I was keeping it rolling around with my tongue the whole time, and I think I still freezer burned my tongue a little bit. 3, 2, 1. Water, liquid nitrogen. It's clearly boiling the liquid nitrogen because everything makes liquid nitrogen boil. But when you put it into the water, it just dissipates immediately. You can keep putting it in too. There's just, doesn't stop dissolving. The stuff in the liquid nitrogen, completely intact. And let's take the stuff in the liquid nitrogen and now put it into the cup of water and see what happens. That is odd. I think it's dissolved. So we expected our cotton candy to just freeze in the liquid nitrogen and then kind of shatter the way it did with flowers. Flowers and plant life, of course, are full of water on the inside, and that can freeze very solid, causing things to be extra brittle. But I did think that cotton candy would be a little bit more like a plant and a little bit less like a cotton ball. Guys, there's more for you to see. That little box up at the top will transport you to our last video in case you missed it. You should go check it out. The box at the bottom will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next, and this bomb here in the center will subscribe you to our channel so you never miss another video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.